So our next semi-final is women's doubles, and looking at the women's, well, that's the women's singles draw, isn't it? And Akane Yamaguchi is safely through to the final, and she'll play either Kirsty Gilmore or Busanan Ongbang Rangpan of Thailand. So still hope for Thailand in the women's singles. So our next semi-final is women's doubles, as I say, and coming on to court, pair from Hong Kong, who reformed their partnership earlier this year. Former world number nines Poon Lok Yan and Si Ying Suet. Suet is the left-hander, appearing today in their second semi-final of the year, having reached the semi-final of the Canadian Grand Prix. And their opponents are the Commonwealth Games gold medalists from last year, Vivian Hu and Woon Ki Wei. So both pairs consist of a left and right hander. Woon Ki Wei is the left hander as far as the Malaysians are concerned. Not only a gold medal from the Commonwealth Games last year, but also a bronze medal from the Asian Games in Incheon in Korea. So the Hong Kong pair, what a welcome return they are to the World Tour. They were quarterfinalists here 3 years ago when they were the number two seeds. And of course, I've just given you duff information there, because it was the Malaysians who were the number two seeds 3 years ago and reached the quarterfinal here. But for Poon Lok Yan and Si Ying Suet, Poon Lok Yan is 24 years of age. Her partner, Si Ying Suet, is going to turn 24 in 9 days' time. Wouldn't it be a lovely early birthday celebration if she could get through to the final here? So the Hong Kong pair in the white T-shirts. Yeah, there she is, celebrating her birthday on the 9th of November. So they're making their first appearance here. And no pair from Hong Kong has ever won a Grand Prix gold women's doubles title. So they're hoping to continue on to make history here in Saarbrücken. Number 33 on the world ranking, but don't really pay much attention to that. They have been as high as 9, and it was because they split their partnership last year and only reformed it at the Sudirman Cup earlier this year. The Sudirman Cup, the World Mixed Team Championships, their first tournament was the Australian Super Series earlier this year. So they've been in 3 finals throughout their career. As a pair, they've won 1 Super Series title, the 2012 Japan. But the last final that they reached was the Vietnam International, which was 31 months ago. So the Hong Kong pair, having tried out with other partners, have come back refreshed and rearing to go. And I think they are a quality pair, I really do. And I expect them to shoot up the world rankings when they've played more tournaments. As far as Vivian Hu and Woon Ki Wei are concerned, Vivian Hu, the right-hander, is 25 years of age. Woon Ki Wei, a year older. Left-hander is just practicing her serve there. Born in Selangor, her partner born in Kuala Lumpur. They're currently number 10 in the world ranking, enjoying their second week at a career-high number 10. We've already been in a couple of finals this year. As we look at our court officials for this semi-final, Yasin Sairali from Mauritius and Iris Matspalu from Estonia is the service judge. Yes, the two finals that the Malaysians have been in. The India Grand Prix gold in Lucknow, and also reached the final of the Southeast Asian Games in Singapore.
Ladies and gentlemen, on my right, Poon Lok Yan Te Ying Suet, Hong Kong, China. And on my left, Hu Vivian Ka Moon, Woon K Wei, Malaysia. Woon K Wei to serve to Poon Lok Yan, Lavol, Ble.
So the number four seeds, Vivian Hu and Woon Ki Wei, getting this semi-final underway. Now, don't be surprised at this. The Malaysian pair often are very defensive in their style, especially in the early stages. And I watched their match yesterday against Heather Olver and Lauren Smith from England, and they were very defensive in the opening game, which they lost 16-21. And then they just seemed to wear down their opponents, winning 21-16 and 21-9 in the decider. Malaysians have only played two matches because they had a bye in the first round. But then the Hong Kong pair have only played two matches because in the second round, they received a walkover from the 2013 winners, Ifia Muskins and Selina Peek of the Netherlands. Oh yes, that's well taken by the left-handed Si Ying Suet.
3-1.
Yesterday, the Hong Kong pair beat Super Jirakul and Tevrat Tanachai of Thailand in three games. Hour and 1 minute it was. So both of these pairs having three-game matches in the quarterfinals yesterday. Oh yeah, that's nice. Lovely play. Well, this is actually the second meeting between these two pairs. The first time they met was way back in 2012 in the first round of the All England Championships. And it was the Hong Kong pair that won in three games on that occasion. Having dropped the opening game. Eventually won 21-18 in the decider.
6-2.
Just delightful, isn't it? We saw that in the women's singles, those angled slow drops. Yeah. Left-hander was weighted, committed to the forehand defense, and the shuttle aimed towards her left, her right shoulder, which calls for a left-hander. It's very, very difficult. Oh, service fault called. Struck above the waist, says our service judge. left it wide.
Service over, 5-9.
Oh dear. Well, her partner got called a fault on her last serve, and then Vivian Hu making an error on her serve. And that's gone wide. That's good attacking play. Well, no player from Malaysia has ever won a title here at the Bitburger. Not in any discipline. Well, the Malaysians were hoping to make history, but they're going to have to play more shots like that if that is going to happen. This is nice. This is why I just don't understand why they don't attack right from the start of a match. Oh, goodness me, complete mishit. And that means that the pair from Hong Kong have a 4-point advantage against the number 4 seeds, Vivian Hu and Woon Ki Wei. Chin Yu Hui and Jeremy Yang, the two Malaysian coaches there. Judgment there from Vivian, who could have played it. Yeah, inside that back line. Change of pace. It often happens, you know, with a doubles pairing. Play together as juniors, go into the senior ranks, and then the partnership goes a little stale, and it's good to have 18 months or so playing with somebody else. Then you come back together again refreshed, as this Hong Kong pair have done. And our last semi-final of the day, exactly the same thing has happened with the Danes, Mads Conrad and Mads Culling. That's lovely, isn't it? Change of pace. I'm always saying change of pace in the attacking play. As long as it's going in a downward direction in doubles, you've got a very good chance of winning the rally. It's very well taken by seeing Suet. Oh, good judgment, well left. Oh, that's the second service error from Vivian Hu. is simply brilliant. Delightful low serve, racket up, ready, looking for the third shot. Serve return and third shot, critical in all doubles disciplines. Look, there she is, takes it early. Beautiful. And the Malaysians have followed it up with an error. So now, Hong Kong pair just 3 points from this opening game. It's actually 18-11. Missed it. 19-11. Yeah, that was a better return of serve from Woon Ki Wei. Oh, service fault called. Struck above the waist. Oh no, it racket head too high. Misread the arm signal from our service judge. Total confusion. Good rally. Yeah, second game point is well saved by the Malaysians. Still another five opportunities for Poon and C. Yeah, this time it proves to be third time lucky for the unseeded pair from Hong Kong. Poon Lok Yan and C. Ying Suet. Opening game. As confirmed by the umpire, 21-15 in just 12 minutes of play. Now they're far more positive than their opponents, players from Hong Kong. Far more aggressive in their style of play, and they thoroughly deserve the opening game. 21-15. Well, Chin Yi Wee, the female Malaysian coach there for world number one in the women's doubles with Wong Pei Ti. As far as the Grand Prix gold is concerned, a series of tournaments that's been happening since 2007. Players from Hong Kong have won one mixed doubles title and five women's singles titles. Never a women's doubles Well, they've continued where they left off in the first game, haven't they? Pair from Hong Kong. Just long. Malaysia has such a tradition in the sport of badminton. I was really very surprised when I was looking at past results from this Bitburger tournament, which dates back. The first one was in 1988. Very surprised that no Malaysian player had ever won a title here in any of the five disciplines. There won't be many major tournaments throughout the world where that's the case. Oh, look at that exchange. Oh, brilliant! What a final shot from Woon Ki-wei. Magnificent angle. Look at the rapid fire exchange, first of all. Interception after interception. The two left-handers absolutely battling it out. What a great rally. Super. Question, the longest rally of the match, I'm sure. Oh, well, seemed a desperation shot in the end from Vivian Hu. Suggests that if you're going to use the tactic of just trying to wear down your opponents, you've got to have superior fitness. And that last shot from Vivian Hu looked as if she was a little tired, as if it was desperation because she didn't want the rally to go on. Oh, yes. Well, it was a short lift. It came off the frame of the racket of Poon Lok Yan. Yeah. Short. There was the miss hit. Well, I'm a great believer that you make your own luck, and if you're attacking, then there's more chance that you will get those all-service fault called. I think that's the first time that she's been called in this semi-final. Oh. Oh, that's well taken. Real commitment at the front of the court from Poo Lok Yan. It's a nice return of serve, but look at that. Well taken. Command of the front court area, so important. Good rally. Yeah, three powerful smashes. About the variation. Variation in pace. That's nice from the Malaysians. Well, good discipline from the Hong Kong pair. It's hard work to keep attacking, but it is so worthwhile, the rewards of point after point. Service fault called. Well, I wouldn't mind seeing that serve again. Struck above the waist. I don't disagree. Point advantage at the mid-game interval is with the pair from Hong Kong. Success in mixed doubles as well has Si Ying Suet. Very good all-round doubles player. I remember back 3 years or so, both the Hong Kong players were playing women's singles on the World Tour as well. Good development path, playing all three disciplines, but now concentrating on doubles and mixed. Another good rally. In each other's way, I think.
Wait.
Yeah, in the wrong formation. It's Vivian who to serve, 7-11. Points since the mid-game interval, and 3 points going to the Malaysians. At least two of the shuttles hit long of that back line. Ah, oh, that's well taken. Well worked. So much of women's doubles, I don't think you can really expect to hit winners from the back of the court. Most of the time you should be trying to set it up for your partner to intercept at the net. That's brilliant defence. Goodness me. Oh, it's wide by a whisker.
39.
I like the attempted variation in attack there from the Malaysians. But they miss with another one.
Nine.
Five-point advantage restored. It was a 5-point advantage at the mid-game interval. Yep, well, she's disappointed. I think she was right to go for it. You've got to accept when you're going to try and take these half chances at the net, you've got to accept that occasionally you're going to make some errors. But as I was saying earlier, the benefits, the rewards outweigh the negativity. Just seemed to snatch at that serve. Poon Lok Yan decides that that shuttle's no good. Must have been the shuttle, couldn't have been me. That channel attack down the centre of the court, not only confusing the two Malaysians, but it narrows the angle of reply, and therefore there is that greater chance that the net player can intercept. Sudden, there's a bit of belief with the Malaysians. And a bit of aggression. really hunting the shuttle in that rally. No, only 2 points the deficit. Now it was a great backhand from the left-handed Si Ying Suet. This one here, look at that. That's terrific. Oh, she's found the line. That is inch perfect. There's the one that the channel attack, getting the net player involved. Good work by the players from Hong Kong. Now just 2 points away from their first final in 31 months since the 2013 Vietnam International. Oh, yes. Oh, my goodness. Unbelievable. It's gone long. Good rally. Yeah, now what's the confusion? Not terribly sure.
Shabishova, 20 match point, 16.
Four match point opportunities for the unseeded pair against the number four seeds. And that's gone wide. They convert on their first opportunity. 21-15, 21-16. And Poon Lok Yan and Si Ying Suet. Well, absolutely brilliant today. Look, there's the left-hander speaking to the service judge saying, now what was the problem with my serve? I want to put it right for tomorrow, because tomorrow this pair from Hong Kong, Poon and Si, have a chance to make history and become the first women's doubles pair from Hong Kong to win a Grand Prix gold title. So confirmation of the score once again, 21-15, 21-16 in a match lasting 34 minutes. Now they take leave of the court. Next up is men's singles. And the only home player left in, Mark Schwiebler of Germany. Twice he's been in the final previously. Twice he's lost in the final. Can he go one better this year? Well, he's got to get through the semi-final first. Well, there we can see that tomorrow's women's doubles final will be a Hong Kong-China affair. Seven different nations involved from that quarter-final stage. That's always healthy to see, but only one seeded pair, and that was the number four seeds, Poon and Woon, that we have just seen being beaten by the Hong Kong pair. So our next semi-final is men's singles, and Mark Schwiebler, the left-handed German, the number three seed, up against number 12 seed Wong Wing Kee from Hong Kong. So here is Mark Schwiebler, the 31-year-old from Bonn here in Germany. Today appearing in his sixth semi-final at this particular tournament.